Hello again. I'm back, and Gunther's U47 is at about 100 meters or so. We're waiting for this one destroyer to give up on us and return to her battle group. She was part of an escort of a larger warship that we weren't able to actually get a look at, but we could hear her. And based on the sound, she was probably a large warship, either a large cruiser or a small battleship. But we're waiting for that destroyer to leave. We were right on the bottom here for a little while. We took some depth charge damage on our way down, but we evaded her using some decoys and backtracked on our course a little bit. And so I'm gonna take a listen and see if the destroyer is still out there. I don't think it is. I've been listening every now and then. It seems to be getting fainter. We're doing about 1.5 knots with silent running. Yeah, I know. I don't hear a destroyer, so we will pick up speed a little bit, cruise on out of here a little more, and then come back to the surface. It's starting to get dark. It's almost 20 after 5 in the evening. So you can see this is part of my evasion course here. I was up here earlier and I did a little zigzag and came south. Their convoy is actually moving from west to east. There are no merchants in that convoy. It's all battleship, or it's all warships. Destroyers escorting a large warship. And that could be the battleship that was reported earlier to be in Scapa Flow, but they're saying that she's still there. But we don't know that since we're underwater and we haven't taken any new radio messages. So that's old intelligence. So I'd like to be at Scapa Flow in the wee hours of the morning, like around 1 or 2 o'clock in the morning. Give myself a few hours to get out of there. So I would think it's pretty safe to say that the that battle group is quite a ways away, because they were up here and they were steaming at about 13 knots this way, so they're way away from me now. So I think it's pretty safe to surface, but I'm gonna come up and take a peek anyway, just to make sure. Coming up. bit of a sea state up there. Looks pretty clear. And surface.
Surface the boat.
All right, so let's plan on getting in a Scapa Flow when it's nice and dark outside. So I'm doing about 7 knots, 6.5, 7 knots in the sea. I'm not going to go at full speed. I don't want to get there too quickly. So if I'm doing 7 knots, you can multiply that by 1.852, that's about roughly 13 kilometers or so per hour. Okay. So it's 13.8 hours. And that's 13.8 hours to get right about here. And right in this region here. Alright, so I'm up here near Scapa Flow. I'm right here. And I've got some sound contacts. Now, I guess this is maybe a little bug in the game, because I was hearing sound contact through this island, and there's no way the ship is over here, because it's just too close and it doesn't sound like it's that close. So it sounds more like it would be at this distance if there were no island there. So I put a mark here, just because that's one contact. Also had another contact out here, so there could be one here. That's still, I guess, part of Scapa Flow. And then there's one that's right around here somewhere. This mark here I made earlier is just a super mark for me to. That's where I wanted to be by about 3 a.m. or so. But I got some good luck on the way over. I got some wind and some current that gave me an extra 4 knots. So I'm here ahead of schedule. Now it's nice and dark outside. So I'm gonna continue motoring on the surface here.
Surface the boat.
Go ahead and get to the top. Can't see anything out here, which is good for us. Cloudy, some stars. I'm gonna pick up my speed.
Extreme speed ahead.
Alright, so it's almost 2 a.m. Or let's see, we got about 20 minutes or so before 2. I think this target out here might be coming out, and it sounded to me like it was probably a destroyer or something. Like a large destroyer, possibly a light cruiser. I'm gonna let that contact go by me if that's the case. So now I've got a little bit of headway here. I've got some, I guess it's the current that changed or something, or winds, but I've lost about 5 knots. So I need to get up in here soon. This is what Gunther Prien did in October 1939 with his U-47. And that's what I'm trying to simulate here. He snuck into the Scapa Flow and sunk a battleship. All right, well, I'll get back with you when the action starts. See you in a bit. Always mark the same spot. So I see he's at about 950 meters or so. Right? That's roughly 316.66 meters in a minute. You multiply that times 60. And that gives you 19 kilometers per hour. So if you divide that by 1,000, so 19 divided by 1.852, that gives me 10 knots, 10.25 to be exact. Seems like he's going a little faster than that for some reason, but that's what I got. So I'm going to start putting in my my information. Got him just over a hair, over 10 knots. Now, here's his course. Like that. And I'm almost at 90 degrees here with him, I bet. So if I draw an angle here to my ship, yeah. Well, it's going to be a little bit off, so 90 would be here. Doesn't quite look right. Try that again. Draw along the line until you're lined up with your ship, to your ship's course, and right to your bow. Oh, I am at 90, look at that. That's good. And my range is going to be 1800 meters. It's going to be a little closer by the time I stop, because I'm going to stop my engines. While I'm doing that, I'm going to adjust the angle on the bow. I'm going to be looking at his port beam here at 90 degrees. My bearing is going to be 360, because I'm going to be looking right at him when I shoot him. Right, I'm going to wait until he passes right in front of the boat, so he's going to be at 0 degrees or 360 degrees relative to my bow. He's getting here. He doesn't know I'm here yet. He hasn't spotted my periscope yet. Too far away. Sea state's too high. That's one advantage of having a little higher sea state, although it can kind of get in the way a little bit if you're looking at your contacts. They have a much harder time spotting a periscope. It's almost impossible, especially at night. I'm drifting a little bit, 1 knot. He's going to be about he stays on this course, which I hope he does. 1600 meters or so. Put that in. Okay. I'll open my torpedo bay doors.
Flooding tube locked. Flooding tube two.
Fire spread.
Switching to saddle shooting.
But I think, well, I don't like to waste my torpedoes. I don't have a whole lot left. I'm hoping that one will do it.
Switching to single tube shooting.
I'd like to get a better look at him so I know who he is. What he is. Know if I have if I'm close enough to be able to tell that yet. He got a lot of trees in a way, so it's harder to see his profile. I know it's a warship, but I just don't know what kind yet. I'm pretty sure it's a warship. Maybe it's not. Maybe it's a merchant ship. Hard to tell. He's going a little bit, come to think of it, he's going a little bit slow to be a warship. Usually they're cruising at about 13 to 15 knots or so. He's only doing 10. You know what? He might just be a merchant ship. Yeah, he is. Alright, that's fine. Take him out. So I made a little bit of an adjustment on his range since he looks like he may have spotted me. He's either spotted me or he is he's just changing course. He may just be changing course. So this is going to make it a little more difficult now, since he's changed his course. Yeah. No, I should probably fire on him now, but I don't want to waste torpedoes on a merchant ship. So I'm not going to radio in the contact because I don't want the enemy to be able to make a fix on me, and number one, know that I'm there, number two, be able to come and get me. So I'm gonna let this guy go. Say what? Yeah, I'm gonna let him go. If he was to stay on this track here, that would have been an easy one shot. Just set the magnetic our pistol and set the depth to just below his keel and blow him in half with one torpedo. But I don't have a lot of torps left, and I want to reserve these for any battleships or whatever, or warships that might be in Scapa Flow, because that's what Gunther Prien did. And since I am kind of simulating his control, I'm going to let this guy go. Yeah. The crew is probably like, what are you doing? Let's get this guy. No. Uh-uh. Let's turn around.
Oh, he's ahead.
So now I see where he's, what kind of course that the merchants are taking here. They're coming out of Scapa Flow here, and then they turn. And that's very useful information. And they might do the same when they come in. So when I leave, there might be some merchant ships coming in. I might be able to take out a merchant ship or two on my way out. I'm still underwater. I'm at snorkel depth there. He should be far enough away from me. I might be able to surface. He's going to be down here somewhere. They can't see more than maybe 3 kilometers or maybe even less than that. So it's getting late, so I'm going to surface the boat. Let me take another listen for contacts real quick while I'm underwater. It's 909596 would be here. Okay. Should hear the merchant ship. Hear the difference. Looks like he's much closer. That's what a merchant sounds like. The other sound, although it's far away, it's a low, kind of slower, kind of low. Yeah, that's definitely a merchant. It's a big one. What if he's coming out? Yeah. Maybe I should go this way and then come in. Try that. I'm going to take a risk and surface the ship.
Oh.
shit. Oh, shit. Look at that, he's going in. Fuck that. I know he can't see me now. I've got the range for their view turned off, so but I'm pretty sure his visual range is no more than about 3 kilometers or so. It's too dark out for him to see me. Well, that's. I'm gonna follow this guy in. That's what I'm gonna do. This is kind of cool. I'm low. I'm about 50% battery though, so I've got to be careful here.
Shut down these engines.
I can't see him. I can hear him though. That's him right there. You can't see it, but I can barely see the water crashing against his bow. Going very fast. I have him visually tracked, that's why you can see him here. So I have that, I didn't turn that off. It makes sense that, you know, if you can spot them visually, then, you know, why not have the track on there, because that's what he would have in reality. But I turned the sonar guy off, you know, as far as like his contacts, because I like to do that part of it myself, 100%. And that's just me. And that has to do with, you know, the fact that I used to hunt submarines and I used to be the sonar guy, you know? So, it's kind of a pride thing. Not all warships had acoustic sensors in this part of the war, so some of them, especially the older ships, really, they're essentially blind when it came to acoustics. That's probably what that warship is that he's patrolling.